Daniel Luzer from Washington Monthly said, "The essence of the activity, after all, consists of encouraging fans to get excited about people participating in actual and ambiguous sports, either football or basketball. If cheer is a band, so is the band. There has been huge controversy on the topic if cheer is a sport or not, because a lot of people think that it's not. It's just like girls jumping around and using small skirts and whatever. But according to Inc.com, competitive cheerleading is a sport. It is a physical activity that is governed by rules under which a winner can be declared, and its primary purpose is to compare the skills of participants." I was in cheerleading for 3 years when I was in high school, and yeah, there's some difference between cheering for a sport and doing competitive cheerleading. Competitive cheering for a sport is basically what everyone thinks it is. It's like you just cheer on for your school team or whatever you're cheering for. But competitive cheerleading is something that is required of lots of strength, because you have to lift someone up like a human being, and you have to you have to perform, so like a dance routine, tumbling, which people call doing flips, stunting, which is when you pick someone up, and all under 2 minutes and 30 seconds. Okay, so I'm gonna show you guys a video of what they do. Okay, so that's just an example of what they do. So as you saw, they picked the person up, and they did not just like keeping them up at a height, like a half level, but they threw her, and the flyer had to twist and whatever and stuff. And that requires like a lot of practice, training, as well as physical and mental health. And so according to opposing views, cheerleading isn't a sport. So a lot of people don't think that it's a sport because they view cheerleading as how people, like in the TV, when you watch football or basketball, the cheerleaders are dressed in shorts and a tiny top, and they just dance. That is not a cheerleading team, that's a pep squad, because they don't do any physical activity, they just dance. and they don't really like stunt or tumble or anything. And being mentally and physically prepared is a really huge thing, because you can't just expect from one day to another to be able to lift someone up. You have to go through the process just like any other sport. You're not gonna know how to play basketball or football right off the bat. You're gonna train for months, for years. It's gonna take a long time for you to be able to do something that cheerleaders do. Cheerleading also requires a lot of mental strength, because if you believe that you cannot do something, you won't be able to do it. You need to know and believe in yourself that you, as well as your team, will be able to accomplish what it is that you guys want to accomplish, which is to win. According to LifeStrong.com, cheerleading requires strength, stamina, balance, and timing, and all clear athletic qualities. Collegiate level cheerleaders report spending as much time practicing as their peers in other varsity sports, in addition to attending cheer practice. They do weight lifts as well and work out several times a week. So just like when you play football or basketball, you train for many hours. Cheerleading is the same way. You have to train, and it's even more difficult because it's not, football and basketball can be tough to do because you have to learn all the plays, but cheerleading is more difficult than that because you have to know how to do what you have to do. You need to know how the flyer has to set up, how the bases have to stand, what muscles they need to use in order to pick the person up, and how to do everything correctly so the person doesn't fall and injure themselves. Matt Fellows from dietsandreview.com said, the greatest difference between football and cheerleading is that football requires sheer strength, while cheerleading also requires balance and body control. Balancing a top-heavy 120 pounds in one hand takes much more coordination than running full steam into the guy facing you. He also said, as a cheerleader and in football, the idea is to be explosive. This requires very high energy. The difference is that football players get to sit on the bench when they get tired. As a male cheerleader, I was standing and yelling and giving my all for the entire game. Thank you.